Interesting matchup. His deck is, I don't know. I don't think it's very good, but maybe it's better than I think it is. All right, I'm going to keep a turn two Seeker of the Way with all of our mana available and hope that we don't draw too many lands. If we do, his deck is definitely a type of deck that can just smash us. But if we do, yeah, we do get a Mardu Rough Rider as well. All right, that's a good draw. Does this remind you of anything? Perhaps last game. Oh, I like that. I'm gonna play that instead. A 2/3 versus Valley Dashers. Yes, please. Start eating these Valley Dashers or make him have some type of removal spell for our Horde Chief. And even if he does, we still get to debilitating injury one of them and bash to gain some life back. Goblin Slide, that's not what you want. That is not what you were hoping for that turn. Yes, that is a beautiful thing. Think I just attack with Seeker and Warrior this turn. Play my Scoured Barrens and pass. I don't need to use debilitating injury because I'm going to eat that thing with the Horde Chief and I can't cast Rough Rider yet, so. Let's get in for a few damage here. Play this and just say go. So yeah, plan is to eat the Mardu, eat the Dasher with the Horde Chief, and then see what he's got lined up. Po, Wingmate Rock. Well, that's not fair. How do I deal with this? Well, this explains a lot about why he's in the finals with Goblin Slide Valley Dasher dot deck. goodness sakes. Well, I'm going to be attacking. So this turn is either Rough Rider or Falconer plus injury. I think I attack with Horde Chief. He probably blocks with this bird. And then I probably go debilitating injury your bird and play Falconer. Then I take some damage. He gains some life, but I can at least start to piece together a board with Falconer and Mardu Rough Rider where I can make something to block. And I actually have an attack going back the other way. And if he takes the two, I have to just live with that. If he takes the two, I probably just play Rough Rider. Okay, he did. Assuming that both of these come in, he's got me on a 3-turn clock. He's going to hit me for 6, 12, 18, which is going to kill me. Tormenting Voice to make a token that doesn't do anything or doesn't do a lot. Yeah, we technically win this race as the board sits, assuming that nobody ever blocks again. But this is going to be tight. And he is certainly incentivized to race us here, too. Given that we've got a Rough Rider, so we can make it so, one of his blockers doesn't work anyway. Yeah, he's just going to cash in the goblin for a life. Block here to eat it. And we're going to have to. Uh-oh, what is this? Oh my God. Ride down his last card. Ah, that is nasty. We saw it in the first game, but yeah, I forgot. I'm not going to lie. Okay, so instead of blocking with my Seeker, I block with my Rough Rider, and I lose that. Now, I only took one extra damage from this, but he does have technically lethal here. This game is not over yet, though. I can gain a good chunk of life here. I can play Debilitating Injury on something, probably just the Goblin. And then I can gain life. I can gain, what, 5 life here from the Seeker? Yeah. So let's start with that. I think I want to do this before playing the Falconer because we need to race now. And I think I actually can. I'm going to rethink my blocks with the Rough Rider. Let's just say I know that he has Ride Down. I'm going to figure out what I would have done. But for now, we got to play. So this hits for 479, which is good. And I can also Debilitating Injury here. Could even draw cards if I don't think it'll change the clock too much. Another thing I could do is Debilitating Injury one of these. I'm gaining 4. I'm going to 11. He's going to hit us for 3, 6, 7, maybe 8. Yeah, all right. Let's try to gain as much life as possible. I'm killing the token because I don't believe that it changes the clock, and also because he'll leave that back as a chump blocker, and that could matter huge. And of course, I'm doing it now so that Seeker gets in for extra. All right, so attack with everybody. This hits for 10. And then I've got 3 Raider Spoils triggers. I'm at 12. Yes, for sure, the first one. Aha. So now I'm at 11, and he can hit me for 3, 6, 7, 8, maybe 9 or 10. Do I kill him next turn just with Crater's Claws? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I do. So I'm going to say no here. I'm just going to preserve my life total as high as it possibly can be because I do just... I should be able to just kill him, because if he attacks me with the rocks, then I can hit him with my creatures to take away some amount of damage, and if he doesn't, then I can Crater's Claws him for... Actually, and this will even trigger as well. Oh, this is a super close game. Wingmate Rock is a massive pain. So here's 3, 6, 8. Okay. He's going to gain 3, go to 9. We attack with everything. Pretty sure we got this. Let's see here. 3, 6, 8. We go to 3. We attack with everything. He blocks something. Oh, so now he's rethinking. All right, well, we'll see how this pans out, but I think we got it. Let's see what we draw for the turn. Swamp. Okay. So... if we attack with everything, he goes block, block. Our 2 biggest thing, he takes 2. Yeah, he's just dead. I think he's just dead here, actually. And yeah, we got bombs, too. This is 8, right? Because this guy triggers, gets to 4. Which then triggers Ferocious. And you're dead. Sweet. Wow, we beat a resolved rated Wingmate Rock in Limited. That does not happen that often. And we made a mistake with this Ride Down, I think. I'm trying to think. So the options were Warrior, Seeker of the Way, or Rough Rider. He's got 1 card left in his hand that he had drawn from the Tormenting Voice, so we don't have really any information about that. But the fact that he attacked with a token I should have been able to put that together, given that we had seen ride down before. So the question is, would I rather lose if either not block or lose Mardu, Rough Rider, a Warrior, or a Seeker? Ugh, that's tough to say. I mean, with cards like Raider Spoils and Trumpet Blast in your deck, every creature counts. You certainly don't want to lose them. Anyway, I'll have to look over that, but I'm pretty sure that Mardu Rough Rider was the last choice. I think that was the one I really didn't want to block with, looking back. But it did work out. We drew our Creator's Claws and somehow beat this stupid card. And I think we had it, yeah, a couple of different ways there. Anyway, good draft. That was fun. Some good plays, some mistakes, and so it goes. Thanks, guys, for hanging out, though, with me this week. And I look forward to next time. We'll see you then.